All right.
We're live.
Hey, everybody. What's up? Whoa. We're just about, we're live, but we're just about to start. Get ready, get ready, get ready. How's everybody doing? We miss you. Excited for this warm-up and exercise. All right, let's do this. Welcome to another live Dan the Man Super Kids Gymnastics warm-up slash gymnastic skill, whatever you want to call it. Hi, everybody. It's nice to see you. Thank you for tuning in. Let's start off with running in place. Everybody run in one spot. Good. Try to run and turn in a circle. Now go faster. Now knees up. Good, keep going. Now, tushy kickers, butt kickers. Good, legs apart, squat down, jump. Good, who can do this? Side to side, side to side. Good, now let's go lower. Yes, again. Good. Nice, let's go jumping jacks. Ready, go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. Keep going. 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. Nice. Take a deep breath. How's it going? Everyone warming up? Getting ready? Shake out the shoulders. Good. Twist. Great. When you're twisting, try to turn and look behind you. Good. Who can let their hands just slap and loose? Nice. All right. Knee. Bring your knees up. Good. All right, let's get into it. Let's start off with our stretch jumps. Everybody stand, feet together, super straight and tall, chin straight out in front. We're gonna swing our arms up and do a stretch jump. Stretch, freeze, finish. Again. Again. And one more time. Good. Take a deep breath. Tuck jumps. Ready. Swing your arms. Tuck. Freeze. Finish. Again. Good. Straddle jumps. Take a deep breath first. When you do your straddle jump, remember that you're going to be like sitting in the air in the straddle position. I don't want them just on the sides. I want them out in front just a little bit, okay? So here we go. One. Two. Three. Four. All right, pike jumps. Ready for your pike jumps? Take a deep breath. Are you guys doing it? You ready? All right. Arms up, swing your arms. Pike. Nice. Take a deep breath. Okay, let's do our full turns. I say this every time. Make sure you're not going to bang into anything. If you're nervous, then do a half turn. Okay, remember half turn is like this. Use your arms. And let's go for the full turn. Nice work. Take a deep breath. Great job. Now we're going to sit down in our pike position. Everyone sit up tall. Let me bring in my lovely assistant. Clap hands for the amazing Pearl, everybody. Pike position. Hands up. Go. Reach down. Push yourself. Feel it hurting. It should hurt a little bit underneath your legs, under your knees, okay? Try to get your whole body to lay down. If you can't, grab your ankles, pull yourself down. Okay, go as low as you can. Come on, push yourself. Make it hurt a little bit. Take a deep breath and go lower. Good. Sit up tall. Flex your feet. Pull them up. Pull your feet up. Now, while you do this, look down at your knees. And look up. And look down. Good. Put your hands back behind you and work on your point. Squeeze. So while you're pointing your toes, it's really good to squeeze your kneecaps. Okay? Can you still see us in the other ones? Great. Okay. So remember, while you're doing this, okay, try to squeeze your kneecaps. That will make your whole leg super straight. Okay, point the toes hard, hard, hard. Okay, flex them up, up, up. Do one down and then one up. Switch, switch, switch. Cross the foot, rotate your mushy potatoes. I love mushy potatoes. Believe it or not, I've been saying the mushy potatoes since Galaxy Gymnastics in New York. That is over 21 years ago. I just made it up one day, try the other foot, rotate the other mushy potatoes. And it was the funniest thing in the world. Everyone was like, ah! So I've been doing it ever since. And it's become a Dan the Man staple. Everyone loves to rotate the mushy potatoes. Just joking. Okay, now we're gonna go into straddle position. Okay. Great, arms up, cross your stomach. Reach over to one side. Now, while you're doing this, try to get your ear down. And don't forget, this leg on the other side stays straight and pointed, okay? Good. How low can you go?
can you reach over and get your foot?
Arms up. Reach across. Go to the other side. Good. Don't forget that other leg. Keep going. Nice. Arms up. Higher. Stretch, stretch, stretch. Hide the ears and pancake. How low can you go? Good. When you do this, make sure your toes don't fall inwards. Keep them facing the ceiling, just like that, everybody. Nice. Good. Try to get your elbows down. Good. All right. Butterfly position. Woo. Great work. Face down. How low can you go? Come on. Get all the way down. I see you. All right. Put your face down. Put your ear down. The other ear. Nice. Now we're a diamond. Slide your feet out just a little bit and now go down again. For any of you who don't know, Pearl is my daughter. She used to do gymnastics, but she knows a lot, so she was still helping me out. So I'm very thankful for that. For everybody knew our name. Great. Now we're gonna lay on our stomach. Try to put your feet together and your heels together. Okay, hands facing forward. Knees squeeze together, heels squeeze together, chin goes up. High to your ceiling. High to your shoulder. High to the other shoulder. Circle your head around. Now sit back for cat stretch. Good. Armpits to the floor, everybody. See that? Okay, now go back into the cat, to the seal or snake stretch. But this time, we're going to make our shoulders do all the work here. See, my elbows stay straight, and I'm just going in and out of my turtle shell here. See that, everyone? Good. Three more. One, two, three. Good. That's really important work. All right, sit back for cat stretch again. Good. Maintain the real stretch in the armpits. Okay. Great. Now camel stretch. A lot of you know how to do this camel stretch. You're going to interlock your fingers just like this. If you don't want to do it like that, you can do it like this. Okay, whatever way is comfortable for you. Stretch the shoulders. Don't put too much pressure on the head. And last time, we actually went over a different way to stretch our shoulders. So let's go back to that one where we sit down, put our hands behind us, and stretch our shoulders that way. So you touch your pinkies together like this while they're on the ground. And then you just slide the tush forward, and you stretch out the shoulders. Good. While you do that, look to one side, then look to the other side. Now make your legs straight out in front of you. Now lift them up. And back down. Good job. All right, shake out the shoulders. Nice. Can you go forward? Can you go backwards? Wrists, make waves. Go this way, go this way. This way, All right, shake it out. All right, now we're going to work on our bridges. Bridges. All right, so lay down in a flat back position. Get really close. Yeah, there you go. More, more, more. Keep going. Yeah, that's great. All right, so flat back. Everybody knows the flat back. Pointed toes, super straight arms. Ready, set, go. Get your hands and feet in the right position. Push yourself up. Notice how she pushes her legs super straight. But that only matters when your shoulders are going over the hands. See how her shoulders are over her hands? Just like that, everybody. Okay, hold that. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Come on down. Hug your knees, rock and roll. When you're coming down, don't just splatter down, everybody. Slowly come down. It's good to tuck your chin in. Some people don't know what tuck your chin means. Tucking your chin is just making your chin go down, okay? When you're doing a tuck position, it's good to have your chin tucked in also. Okay, let's do 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Blues come down, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Reds come down, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Silvers come down, and pearl come down. Great. That's awesome. All right, let's work on our splits. So everyone get into a lunge position on your knee. Instead of standing lunge, you're going to do like a knee lunge, okay? You're going to step a little further out so you can start stretching the inside of your back leg, okay? Stretch it as low as you can go. Let me move back so you can see curls. Good. This is something you all can work on every day by yourself. By the time we're done with this quarantine, if you practice all this stuff, you'll be like awesome at it. And you'll come in here and you'll be like, whoa, Dad, check it out. I can do all this stuff now. And really, it's all from practice. Stretching, flexibility, and strength like that, I'm telling you, work hard and you'll get it. Okay, now let's straighten the front leg. Sorry, that took a long time. And now try to get your face down. Good. Good. Can you go reach out towards your hand? Nice. Good. Now slide down into your splits as low as you can go. Good. Make sure your chest and belly button is facing towards your toe. Can you do one towards the camera so they can see? Great. So if you notice, she's actually on the line right now, which is awesome. So she's super straight and her chest and face are facing towards her foot. Okay, some people turn in like this, it's not correct. And then you will never be able to do aerials correctly and other moves and even just a split correctly. So now let's go to our other leg. Everyone, keep working hard. You're doing great. Okay? Now, again, put your leg out in front. Stretch the inside of the hip. Good. Good. Push yourself down as low as you can go. That's it. All right. Now the front leg. Do mine. Now, for me, I start off high and I slowly, gradually go down. The more you breathe, the easier it is. So you take a deep breath, then you go lower. Yes, it hurts. It does hurt. All right, slide down into your splits as low as you can go. Great job. Remember, point that toe. The back leg too is nice and straight. Awesome job. These are things you can look at. Now, if you can't go down all the way and you're just like this, that's okay. Go as low as you can, but still maintain straight leg in front and back too.
This way you know for sure you're doing it correctly, okay?
It's okay if you don't go down all the way. Obviously you want to be able to though, okay, everyone? All right, let's work on our middle splits now. Let's stand in a straddle position. Okay, put your hands down on the floor. Now slowly slide your feet out as far as you can go. Okay, if you want to go down to your elbows, you can. Now Pearl can go down really low. Now that's okay if you can't. Okay, so if you just want to go down to, you know, to this position. Now it's important. I see some people, they start going down lower and their legs start to bend. But no, not at all. Keep them super straight. It's more important to keep it really straight than to go all the way down. If you can go down with them all the way, go down all the way straight, then that's obviously awesome. Okay? All right. Nice work. All right. Now we're going to work on our candles. Okay? Everyone start laying down on your back. Let's work on a flat from flat back position. So everyone go back to flat back. Now put your hands down below next to your hips, perfect. And now lift your feet up in the air and put your hands on your hips. Okay, this is a candle position, easiest one. I'm gonna do one really close to you guys so you can see. Okay, you're gonna put your hands down and then you're gonna go up and put your hands on your hips. Okay? Once you get really good at this, you can really just stay in this position for a while. It's actually really good for you. Who can do this position and ride a bicycle? Good. How about straddle? How about scissors? Can you go all the way to split? All right, come down. Now we're gonna go up into the candle with our hands down on the floor, keeping them there the whole time. Okay. Ready, set, go up. Don't forget to point your toes and straighten your legs, okay? Now you're really on the top of your shoulders. Good. And down. Let's do that one again. Ready, set, go. Up. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Nice. All right, let's try the hardest one, which is basically a hollow body candle with your arms up. Okay, so you're gonna go here. And stretch, jump, up, back down. Stretch, jump up. Back down. Keep going. Two more. All right. Nice work. All right, everyone, I think it's time for you to get a quick drink of water. Take a deep breath. Let's all get a quick drink of water. You don't need one? All right, let's move on. All right, we're gonna start working on our front levers now. So start in lunge position. Everyone get into your lunge. Nice. Okay, let me show you real quickly about the foot placement again, okay? Make sure that your foot is facing totally forward. Some people, even if it's a slightly bent in, it's gonna make you go off balance. So straight or a little bit out is okay. Okay, this is for every level, boys and girls. Okay, so start in lunge position. Now you're gonna go into front lever and hold it for 3 gymnastics. Point the back toe, straight leg. See how she's, I'm gonna hold her here because look, everybody stop what you're doing and look, because look at hers. See how she's made the T, the actual T, letter T, okay? Okay, go back, finish. Okay, let's do it again. Everyone, we're gonna do it for 3 gymnastics. Are you ready? On your mark, get set, go. 1 gymnastics, 2 gymnastics, 3 gymnastics. Freeze, nice. On your mark, get set, go. One gymnastics, two gymnastics, good. Three gymnastics, freeze finish. Nice. All right, one more time. Ready, set, go. One gymnastics, two gymnastics, three gymnastics, freeze. Now let me explain, when you're doing this, make sure, I know I said foot placement, but make sure that your stomach or your belly button is facing the floor. Don't let your hip open up and turn out. Okay, so start here and make sure that you're in a nice T position with your hips fully facing the floor. Okay, everyone, get that. We're now we're gonna do our floor touches. We're just gonna do three of them. So you're gonna go front lunge, front lever, then you're gonna do the floor touch, and then you're gonna go back to front lever. Okay, let's do three of those. Here we go. Lunge, get set, go. One gymnastics, two gymnastics, three gymnastics. Back one gymnastics, two gymnastics, three gymnastics. Ooh, that's hard, right? Let's try it, let's try it. Ready, set, go. One gymnastics, two gymnastics, three gymnastics. Touch, one gymnastics, two gymnastics, three gymnastics. I mean, she's amazing. Now, she's making it look easy, okay? Try your best at home to keep up with Pearl. Here we go. One more. On your mark. Get set. Go. Front lever. One gymnastics. Two gymnastics. Three gymnastics. Touch. One gymnastics. Two gymnastics. Three gymnastics. Very nice. Okay. Normally, at this point, we'd start moving into handstands, but I know it's really dangerous for some of you at home to do handstands. If you have mats at home, or if you have someone put down something safe for you to do it, then you can move into front lever into handstands. Let's watch Pearl do a few of those. Okay, lunge. Okay, go for it, Pearl. Front lever, handstand, back down. Great. Okay, do three of them. Okay, just so people can get a feeling for it and give them a chance to try if they want to at home. Okay. Now, the modified version, do one more. I'm going to show you right now for people who cannot do this and for also for people who don't have a safe area to do it, okay? We worked on this last time. It's our hurt puppy or one-legged bear walks, okay? See this? This is really awesome. Kick it up. See if you can touch your feet together, okay? Try 10 of those. Okay, always keep this leg very, very straight. Okay, practice 10. All right, everybody? Keep going, keep going. I'm gonna wait for you to finish. Keep doing more. Again, hands down, leg up, kick up, touch. Okay, keep going, 10. When you're done with 10, we're gonna move on to our forward rolls. All right, so we're gonna do some forward roll work, and if you don't have a mat, I mean, by this time you should all know that we're gonna be using some mats and stuff, and I mean, you can even throw down like 5 blankets or something if you need to do the forward rolls. Okay, we're not throwing ourselves down, we're slowly putting our hands down, rolling, okay? We're going to start in the straight body position. Put your hands by your sides. Sure. Not at the same time. Okay, yeah. Ready? Okay, watch what I do, everybody. I put my hands down. I put my head in. I slowly put the back of my head down. Roll and then stand up, no hands. Okay? Watch it from the side angle from Pearl. Good. Okay, let's do it again. Okay, when you do it, I'm going to show you how slow I do it. Okay,
hands down. Okay, now one thing that people get confused with is if they put their hands far from their feet, there's no way for you to really do a roll unless you're going to do a super jumping one. So get your hands close to your feet and now slowly put your head down under. And then roll,
okay? You don't really want to fall and put any pressure on your head or neck. Okay? Go for it, Pearl. Arms up.
Slowly.
Good. And we're all working on trying to stand up with no hands. Okay? Let me show you one more time.
See this no hands stand up position? This is something you can practice on your own. Just going from rocking and rolling to this on your feet position, okay?
All right, nice work. Forward rolls, you can do a whole bunch of different rolls. You can do straddle rolls, pike rolls. We did them last week. Okay, I'm gonna show you one straddle roll and one pike roll. Okay, these are things you can implement into your daily, or just practice it. Be like, hey, wasn't able to do it when Dan was showing, so let me start practicing this every day now. Okay? So straddle rolls, or I'll let Pearl show the straddle roll. My hamstring's a little pulled right now, so here we go. This one, you're allowed to touch the floor on the stand-up. Notice how she pushes down and leans forward, okay? Can you show it from the side angle? Okay? Again, you need a safe area to do this, but it's really fun to try. Good. Now the pike, I'll do the pike one. Here, I'll do the pike one and go this way. Let's see if I can do it. Yeah. All right. So those are some challenges you can try on your own, okay? Now we're gonna move on to let's do our fun challenge and then we'll start doing our hard workout conditioning stuff. So for today, let me grab it. Okay, so you can grab a few different things. You can grab, I grabbed paper towels or napkins because I figured everybody will have a paper towel or a napkin. Okay, if you don't have that, you can grab some string. You can grab, what did I also, like some wires, like the small little cords you use for charging. Okay, so what we're trying to do here is we're making like a gap, okay? So we're gonna start off with a really small gap. All right, here, I'm gonna fold mine to make them small. Okay? So, first we're gonna start jumping here. Pearl, why don't you do it for me? All you're gonna do is stand over here and jump over forward, okay? Just forward, not backwards. Okay, so everybody try this. Now what we're gonna do is you can use a piece of paper. I mean, if you need to, rip a piece of paper, you know what I mean? And then put it down right here and do it. Okay, whatever you need to do. All right, so we're gonna jump over and do a freeze. Okay, we're working on our freeze position right now, jumping over, and then we're gonna make the lake or river bigger and bigger. All right, are you ready? Get set, go, jump over, freeze. Good, did you do it? Now, remember before we were practicing our jump half turns. Okay, arms go up, turn, jump half turn. Ready? Watch, jump half turn. Good, now you're gonna jump back over this way. Freeze, finish, and jump half turn. Good, again. Well, actually, now that we made it back and forth, I think we should make our gap bigger. And you, all of you at home, make your river larger, okay? We're gonna keep trying different things with a larger and smaller gaps. Okay, here we go. Same thing, jump. And half turns. And jump. And half turn. And let's do one more. I'm gonna make Pearl's really large, because I know Pearl can do it, but it's a broad jump. Remember, it is both feet together, standing right in front, and jump over. Ready, set, go. Super jump, freeze, and finish. Jump half turn. Good, everybody, and jump. These are some fun things you can be doing at home. Now, we're gonna try to do it back to the same small beginning, but backwards. All right, Pearl, show us how it's done. No, turn around and jumping backwards. Oh yeah. Jump backwards. Good. Now jump and turn again. Half turn. and then you're gonna jump backwards again. Jump half turn. Now we're gonna make it bigger. Jump half turn and jump. Good, and now let's do one really big one. This is challenging. Backwards jumping is way harder. She made it, but you notice when she jumped forward and she jumped way easier for her. That's hard, right? It's good. All right, so now we're gonna move on to doing it. Actually, let's just do this. Let's move on to the next one was stepping over. Okay, so you're gonna put your bat in the river small again. And now you're gonna stand with both feet in front of the first one and then you're just gonna step over. Good, and then you're gonna turn around and you're gonna step over. Now we're gonna make it bigger. Step over, turn around, step over, good, and one big one. Good, turn around, and one more big one. All right, now we're gonna do a little jump, kind of leap, and land in arabesque position. So instead of, it's not a running or a chasse at all. You're basically just going to stand right in front and you're just going to jump over like you're stepping and land in your arabesque. Okay? All right, everybody. Get your gap, your river ready. Get set. Go. Good. Try to hold that position. Okay, turn around. See, it's tricky for Pearl, too. Good. Now let's make it larger. Good. When you land, bend your knee that you're landing on. This way it gives you a little bit of a cushion and stops you. It's like a freeze. Okay, here's a really big gap. All right, that's pretty good. All right. Now, okay, next is going to be, it's the chasse leap. So you're gonna start a little further back and you do a little chasse. You mean to move it back? Good. Okay, so you do a mini chasse. Now, before we do the actual leap part, let's work on just chasseing. So when you do a chasse, one foot goes in front of the other, okay? And here, I'll start from further back here so everybody can see me. Okay, so you're gonna put your arms out and you're gonna go up, step. And as you step, you hop up into the air and the back leg kicks the other leg. Okay, whoa. Okay, and you wanna try to point your toes in the air. Okay, your hips are facing forward the way that you're going. Okay, for this one, so you're gonna do, let's just work on chasseing across, okay? No jumping over the river just yet, okay? Just go for it, bro. Practice a few chassés. Good. Back. Chassé, everybody. Good. Okay, now we're going to do chassé and try to leap over. Okay? Chassé and leap over. Nice. Again, again, again. Let's practice this 5 times so everyone gets a chance to do it. Good. Keep going. Notice how she lands and tries to freeze and stop it. Okay, you can do that. You can also step out afterwards too if you want to. Keep going. All right, one more. I think that was really fast. Great. All right, now I think we should make the gap really big. And let's see. We'll try a few times with a super big gap. Okay, everyone? Everyone, boys and girls, try this, okay? Nice, Pearl. Do it again. All right, Let's challenge Pearl. All right. So these, again, these are some things you can just practice at home. And it's safe because it's a napkin. Okay. For the last one, I wanted to do a, I taught the team this the other day. It's called Fuete. Okay. You're going to basically do a chasse leap. And then you're going to go chasse. And then in the middle of it, in the middle of it, you're going to switch. So you're going to go here and land. Okay. This is tricky to do. Okay, so you're gonna go chasse. It's tricky. Okay, if you don't, it might be easier just using one to start. So chasse. Okay, practice that one. As you can see, I need to practice myself. Okay, that was fun. Okay, so. Now I think we're just going to do a quick workout at the end here. So everyone get ready to do some conditioning. Let me see what I got planned. Oh yeah, we didn't even get to do the plank. Okay, well, that's okay. Okay, we're going to start doing some push-ups. So everyone get down in the push-up position. Okay, we're going to do 10 push-ups, 10 sit-ups, tuck-ups and V-ups and all that. Okay, let's start with the 10 push-ups. Okay, I'll do it this way and Pearl can go that way. Okay, let's see if we can get this done in the next 5 or 10 minutes. Here we go. I'm doing mine on my knuckles because my wrist is still hurt. Tried doing a kick flip about 6 weeks ago and fell on my wrist. So make sure you wear your wrist guards when you're in your padding. Okay, here we go. 10. Nice hollow shape. And go. 1, 2. Now, for people who are having a hard time with this one, it's okay to do it on your knees, okay? I'd rather you get some workout in trying to do it than not do it at all. And if you're gonna be like, oh, God, okay? So I'd rather you have a nice, tight position, squeeze the hollow as you're going down to your push-ups on your knees. If you notice, I'm still hollow while I do that. I'm tightening my stomach and core, okay? All right, that was good. Now we're gonna do some tuck ups. Okay? Let me face it. All right, ready? We're gonna do 10 tuck ups. We go here, tuck. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Keep pointing your toes, 2, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good. Guess what? Now we're going to do the V-ups. Okay? 10 V-ups. Ready. Set. Go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 10. Good. If you noticed, halfway through, I went like this for my first few of them. Okay, that kind of helps you throw your body up there, but it also stops your some of your muscles from getting stronger. So if you start here, you're using a lot more core instead of throwing your arms. Yeah, that was good though. All right, next is frog jumps. Go for it, Pearl. 10 frog jumps. How about this? Let's do 5 frog jumps. And then 5 frog tuck jumps. Oh, yeah. Okay, everybody get ready. Get set. Go. Reach up hard. 1, 2. Hard. Come on. 3. You can do it. 4. That's it. 5. Now you're going to jump and try to do a tuck jump in the air. You ready? Set. Go. Knees up. Get your knees up. Good. That's tricky. That was good. Okay, now we're gonna do plank position. We're going to do push-up position. Without doing push-ups, we're going to go to elbows and up and down, okay?
So we're going to go...
Okay, everyone got this position? Nice hollow body position. Okay, now you're going to go up and down. Up and down. What's really good is to switch and do the other arm instead of just getting up on the same side each time. So right, left, right, left, right, left. The whole time I'm tightening my core. Two more. Left. All right. Nice work. Okay, what's our last thing? Is our tiptoe raises. Okay?
So everybody,
yeah, you want to face forward? You want to face sideways? Okay, you're going to go up and down on your tiptoes. Let's do 30 of them. Oh yeah, starting to burn. Nice. All right, now that you've done that, shake out your legs a little bit, twist them around, turn them. Good, twist out the body a little bit. Good, put your hands behind your back, interlock them into this position, and take a deep breath. All right, I have to say, that was so much fun. It was a great workout. And stay tuned for a few things. We're gonna be posting some challenges, some other fun videos for a lot of different ages. Also on Thursday, we're gonna go live for our 3 and under kids again. So it's gonna be really fun. Before we say goodbye, is there anybody who is waving to us out there, wants to say hi? Feel free to reach out. Also, send us a comment or a post or anything. We had a lot of fun. See you next Tuesday at 4:30. Or if you have a young one, we'll see you at 10 o'clock in the morning on Thursday. Okay? All right, everyone. Peace out from Dan the Man Gymnastics. Bye. Thank you.